Hello, folks, and welcome back to... Oh, sorry, kitten. Welcome back to Total War Warhammer. As always, of course, I am Falcon, your host, and you have kitten butt all up on this, all up in the camera. All up in the camera. Kitten butt for days. Okay, so I did refight this battle off camera. Did still lose it. I don't think there's a way I actually can win it. Mostly because of these giants. I did a lot of damage to this army, though. I did more damage to him this time than I did the first time, I think. And managed to... I mean, lost basically this entire infantry army. Because they just got absolutely slaughtered. Managed to save the heroes here. Lost, unfortunately, most of my cavalry, though. So these two armies that did survive are basically destroyed. They're going to have to come back and... completely rearm, which is gonna take a while, unfortunately. Not much I can really do about it, though. It's just the way that it's gonna be, really. There's nothing I can really do to undo it or to fix it. It's just the way it is, so. I am making a stupid amount of money per turn now, though, so that's good. This army is going to be full strength. This army I can easily make full strength. I am holding off for the moment, because I want to get one of the more powerful units, which I can't presently build in this city, because it doesn't have the fucking armory. But I want to put, I don't know, something in here. I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to put here, but we want something. I just don't know precisely what. Or I could build a... You know what? Fuck it. Let's build a Hellblaster. We'll do that for the Emperor's army. That's cool. So that'll give me two full unit armies there. I'm hoping the dwarves are still assigned to kill this army. So I'm hoping that they do that. If they attack them, they should kill them. Or if the Chaos guys attack them, that they should lose. So, we'll see. I'm hoping that that goes the way that I am anticipating it going. Unfortunately, Varg is sending more armies down here, so I probably am not going to be able to peel these two armies away now. We'll see. But I don't anticipate actually being able to free them up, unfortunately. The army down here, I'm actually probably going to get rid of these pistoliers and replace them with something better. And of course, you're going to turn into a full army again. I'll probably get rid of these spearmen too and replace them with something else. We'll see. We'll see. I do have some things being built here, some stuff upgrading. So hopefully, we should be able to move forward here with... upgrading these armies as much as possible. Let's go ahead and end the turn. I did, of course, do all my moving off camera. Nothing really too spectacular to speak of. So we've taken a couple of serious losses in the last couple episodes, which is not good, but we've destroyed a lot of enemy forces, too. Unfortunately, we're not really making any actual progress. So there's that. We do have the Grand Alliance, though, and it looks like our... allies are finally actually doing something with themselves, because up to now they've been basically fucking useless. Yeah, that's, I figured that was gonna happen. I'm like, yeah, you go ahead and attack the dwarves. Let's see what you see how it goes for you. Poorly. That's how it goes for you. What are you doing, dumbass? Turn around, go do something. You useless fucks. I swear. Useless idiots. I don't know what the hell you're all doing. Oh, did they attack the Trollfjord? It looks like they did. No, I am not going to go to war with those guys. You are bloody stupid. Honestly, I'm not sure why you're still at war yourselves, because we have bigger problems, but whatever. Shit, they have another fucking army? Damn it. Well, they're forming another army, I guess. That's not good. So far, they haven't restored these cities, which is good. I don't want them to restore those cities. Hopefully they don't. They probably will at some point, but hopefully they just continue not to do that, because the longer that it takes them to do that, the better off we'll be. We will see, I guess. You can finally be upgraded. I think I'll do that. Nothing else really worth bothering with there. How are you looking? Are you at full strength? No. Close, though. It might be worth sending you across to try to, destroy this army before it forms and destroy that city. Okay, so you guys did manage to destroy the Troll Fjord, so that's good. I have no... Fortunately, it looks like you got tore up pretty good doing it, both from attrition and from the fight itself. So, unfortunately, you probably won't be able to accomplish much else, at the present moment, at least. What I'm going to do, though, is I'm going to tell you to go attack Bjornlein's settlement. No idea if you'll succeed, but, you know, maybe you will. Maybe not. Okay, so you're attacking that. You're attacking that. You're supposed to be attacking that, but you've set your army, like, way the fuck over here for some reason. So I don't know what the hell you're doing, but... whatever. Whatever. Let's actually assign you to attack this, because unfortunately you're not going to succeed, or Bretonnia is not going to succeed at attacking that. Not going to succeed at all at that one. I don't know what you're doing. Okay, you were told to attack that, so hopefully you do. You're doing your own shit down here. You're still fighting Tilia, so I don't have... Oh. You're not at war with... Really? Why are you not at war with the Chaos guys? Greetings, stranger. Oops. That's interesting. I wonder why that's the case. Because I don't think that should be the case. Okay, well, whatever. Oh, am I not at war with the Greenskins anymore? I was. I thought I was, anyway. Maybe not. Maybe not. You'll never actually get up there to attack that, but that's fine. Stalia, who are you been told to attack? You're trying to attack that. Okay. Oh, that's fine. Go ahead and do that. Go ahead and do that. I want to focus on one of these guys in particular, so if we can manage to kill just one of them, we'll be doing a lot better than we are otherwise. You are my vassal, so... Hail to you. Okay, you've been told to attack there. I have enough people being told to attack that, but I think I'm going to tell you to attack the Iceland's conclave instead. Yeah. I think you are still... Okay, no, you already killed him. Good. Good, good, good. Let's send you... I don't know what to really send you, because you've been basically defending me. You've been defending me for so long against enemy forces, and I don't know that I really want to send your army off to do offensive things. Because I'm afraid you're going to die in the process of doing that. Which would be not good, so... This is maybe not a good idea. Because... I don't know. We'll see. If you can go in and destroy Pack Ice Bay, though, that'll be good. Because that'll really weaken these guys. If you guys destroy Ice... Ice Drake, if I can figure out where the hell Doomkeep even is, or if the orcs go up and attack that themselves. And then if I can destroy Ice Pack and somebody hits Bjornlein's, I think that might be the end of... That might be the end of, scaling. I think. Hellspire... Ice Tooth and Vanaheim. Yeah, so that might be it. If you guys destroy the Bjornlings, you destroy Doom, Ice Drake, and I can figure out where the hell Doomkeeping is. I don't know. No, they have another province, it looks like, that I haven't even seen yet. Hellspire Mountains. But that'd be... Still, if we could destroy those two territories, that'll greatly weaken these guys, and they won't be able to do a whole hell of a lot at that point. So we'll see. We'll see. No promises on that one, because we're limited in what I can actually do here, but still, we'll find out, I guess. Alright, so build a blacksmith, get that working, get you upgrading. And this needed to be a Reichsfort. Fortunately, I don't want to spend that money just yet. Just yet. Oops. Hold on. Oh, god damn it. Alright, fine. Do it this way. So I'm gonna send you down here, but because I want to take full advantage of all my capabilities right now, I'm going to have you build a couple of troops while you're moving. They just have to be troops that can be built in one turn. Actually, yeah, get some handgunners. Those are good. Because they're armor piercing. Oh no. Well. No, you need infantry back. You're primarily an infantry army, so I need to get that back. In fact, don't even build that. Build more infantry. You need your infantry forces back. You are a cavalry army, so you need to, as soon as I can drop you out of fucking march, I need you to do your other thing. You're still doing taking up all of my world building slots, which is fine. It's just expensive. But not much can be done about that. You guys are attacking. You did destroy those guys, although you got torn of fucking ribbons from the looks of it doing it. Damn. Yeah, so I definitely can't have you attack anybody then, because you're too badly tore up to be able to attack anybody. So, don't even bother with that, then, I guess. What else was I going to build? There's something else I was just looking at building. I don't remember what it was now. Oh, was it down here? Yeah, it's down here. I wanted to build a... No. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, you're working to build the armory, so yeah, we will be able to build that soon. So yeah, build that, because then we can build the Reich's cavalry dudes, which will be really good. Once all this finishes, that'll give us three territories, basically, that I'll be able to build really good troops at. Which is important. We need that very badly right now. I mean, it doesn't really matter, but go ahead and do that so we can make sure that we can get over there close enough to actually attack the place. And I just have to drop you back into normal thing. You can go in and attack the city. And hopefully you can destroy that city. And once that city's dead, that'll weaken these guys a lot. Also give me a ton of money next turn, so, you know, there's that. Oh, did you finish training? Oh, you did. Okay. I was not expecting that. Maybe don't build that then, because I want to have these guys training troops. We need to have these guys training troops, rather. It's not even like a want, it's a... Yeah, they finally worked for once. Alright, so go ahead and kick the kick the pistoliers out because they are crap. Absolute crap. So kick them out. Train up troops here first because I need this army basically to be able to move forward. Need this army on the front. So train these guys first. Go ahead and get us some... Let's see. Reichsguard? Or do we want some more demigryphs? I don't know. I mean, I know the demigryphs are better, but they're not hugely better, is the thing. They're really not the better by that much of a margin. They're also, Reichsguard also a little bit faster to train, which is not necessarily a minor consideration. Not necessarily a minor consideration at all. Build a couple Reichsguard. Fact. Yeah, fuck it. Go ahead and fill up the whole unit with a Reichsguard. And then you need to build a couple of demigryphs now. And then you're going to get a bunch of infantry after that. You already have your infantry, although I might kick out the spearmen in exchange for greatswords, because the greatswords are just way better. Just way, way better. Where the hell is... Oh, no, that's a gunsmith. Okay. Ah, very good. Yeah, alright, so that's good. So that's got all those troops training. We have a hordes and hordes and hordes of friendly troops that should be doing something with their lives. I've got a bunches of troops being trained all over the place, so hopefully it won't be long until we're able to start going on the offensive again. But for the time being, we're kind of stuck with what we got, basically. It's not a whole lot we could really do right now. So that is a allies in range. That's just on yourself. So this is the better version. Because this is an AoE thing. Okay, so you, 2 turns and you'll be at full absolute full strength. You unfortunately have a while to go before you'll be full, but that's alright. Not much I can really do about that. These guys, I don't know what these guys are doing. But what I'm probably going to do with both of these armies is I'm going to send them up and try to destroy the rest of their territory. If I can. While using these two armies here, once they're reinforced, to move forward and try to take territory over here. Which is going to be expensive and very, very time consuming, but kind of needs to be done. So, yeah. Alright, so let's end the turn. Nothing going on this turn. Hopefully we can really start...
I will hear you now.
What do you want?
My mood is dark.
Yeah, definitely is. Oh, you want 5,000 for military access. You know what? For that, I'll give it to you. You can always take it away again. I can always take it away again. I don't know what you want military access for, though, because... I don't... I mean, I'll take it, but... I don't know what you... I don't know why you're trying to get military access so much. Like, why do you care? I don't know. You know, technically, all I have to do to win the game, all I have to do is kill them, and we don't have to kill these guys. That's not really our objective. It's to kill the vampire lords, keep the one leader of the Chaos guys dead, which we've already done for the moment, anyway. And I mean, yeah, that's really what we're supposed—that's what we're supposed to do. So we don't necessarily have to do all this other stuff that they're doing. But there's only war against the enemy army. Bring them to battle. What army? The one that's over here? Ah, okay. Totally fine with that, because that's what we're doing anyway. That's what we were planning on doing anyway. And we got one group of units, but that's fine, because we're about to kick his ass. So and we should be able to just auto-calc this, because he is going to lose this very badly. Unfortunately, it didn't kill the other army there, but so we definitely want to sack, because I want the money. And then the following turn, we could actually destroy it. Crap, you weren't able to kill these guys. You weren't able to actually kill them. That's not good. I wanted to kill this army. Alright, well, we have to destroy the place next turn, and then you can move in and try to kill him. Where did these guys go? Are you guys leaving? You should be leaving. Unless you're a complete idiot, you should be leaving. Why are you sieging them? Oh no, you're raiding. What are you doing? You should be. You need to kill these guys, not fucking fuck around, dude, because you're about to get. You're about to get murdered when these guys come down here, number one. And number two. What the hell are you doing? You're just being really stupid right now. Whatever it is that you're doing, you're being really stupid. Can't go into raiding mode, can I? No. Oh well. Yeah, it gives us a winded vigor in battle, so we don't want that. Not when we're trying to fight people. Alright, so we need to drop you out of that mode so that you can move into the city and train units. You need to continue on your merry way down to here, because I need other guys. One more turn and you'll be finished, which will free up all my world-building slots, which will be great, because I have enough money now that I should be able to just go wild with building shit, which we need to, because Lord knows we are not in the best of conditions right now. Alright, so let's get ourselves... What do I want to build here? What do I want to build here? Let's go ahead and get a volley gun. Maybe two volley guns. Fuck it, yeah. I've never seen the volley guns, actually, so I don't know how good they are, but that's fine. We've learned that we definitely need some infantry in this force. So let's go ahead and get ourselves a group of infantry training. You're just waiting for your strength to come back. You are just waiting for these guys to finish building, and then we can start doing stuff with you. You can train some troops now, because you're in another territory. We'll solve this problem shortly. So you primarily need spearmen, because you still have all your crossbowmen, so basically we just need spearmen here. And then here we need to build the Reichsfort and a gunsmith we need in this province. Yeah. So get the Reichsfort built. Yeah. So build the Reichsfort. Once this finishes here, I will build a stables here so we can upgrade that all the way to be able to get the stabled infantry or stable troops out of this territory, which is important. You are basically just waiting for this to finish upgrading, and then we can build all the troops in this area. I also kind of want to build one of these because I want to get a Luminarch just for the hell of it, but not super important right this second. Yes, my lord. Alright, so let's make sure, let's go through, make sure all of our stuff is building. Make sure everything is as good as it's going to get. We will go ahead and use up a... We will use a slot here. What is that? What am I building? Oh, the Hellblasters. Okay, that's fine. I will use a slot here to start training a group of... What do I want to build here? Reichsguard, maybe? Yeah, give me a group of Reichsguard. I need to basically be using all of my building slots. Like, all of my, every capability that I have to build stuff, we need to be making use of right now. Because I need to get these armies into, like, full capability. Pretty much. Because we are hurting really bad right now. Hurting really, really bad right now. Wish there was a way to increase our building slots. I don't think there is. I think I wish there was a building that you could do that would do that for you, but I don't think there is. Well, I guess go ahead and build this here. Because then we can build Luminarchs in this area. And that uses up most of the money, so I'm not wasting it. I think every army is training troops now. Every army that can train troops, obviously. Yeah. Not only are they training troops, they're training as many as they possibly can. Alright, so they took that territory, that's a problem, because I don't want them to move into taking Kislev and whatnot. Because I don't want them to have any more territory than absolutely necessary. Because the more territory they have, the harder it is going to be for us to kill them, basically. I'm almost tempted to just go to war with them now so we can try to kill them. Because, see, what we're supposed to do, is I need to take Nordland... I need to take Ostermark, which is the territory they control right now, which we'll take despite killing them, and we need to take Averland. I should maybe... So I could get Averland to join me. Reclaim Sylvania, but that we get that from taking the vampire count, so that's not really that important. Ensure that no military presence belonging to the Warriors of Chaos exists outside of the Chaos Waste. Which is a problem, but... not that serious of a problem. They just have some army up here somewhere. All we have to do basically is just drive them back, and then we can stop them once we manage to push them back to here. So I'm not too horribly worried about that one. It will be a pain in the ass to do, but... Shouldn't be that difficult. I'm actually going to send you down here because we have a quest that we have to fulfill, the Galmaraz quest that requires a mage to be in this area. So we have to deploy a dude in Ostermark, which we just did. So that should trigger next turn. About to say episode, but it's not an episode, it's a turn. what guy is this? The dude is up there, so let's go ahead and take that so that you'll take less stuff while you're in the area. Okay. So next turn you destroy pack ice so then you can kill that army. Stop them from training that army, basically. What the fuck do you want now? No. Sorry. That's not gonna be a thing. Call to arms. What are you fucking idiots doing? What are you doing? I don't understand what the fuck you're doing. Why are you guys fighting each other? Alright, Karak Azor, I'm just gonna let you die then, because you're a fucking retard, so. You're a complete dumbass, so I'm just gonna let you get killed, because fuck you. I don't know what the hell you're doing, but you're an idiot. So, forget it. You know, you just go ahead, you just go forward and die then. Because I am not gonna play with you. You're just completely stupid. I don't know what the hell you're doing, but whatever. I hope the Skull Takers are blowing some shit up here. What are you doing, Nordland? Seriously, destroy a strike forward. What are you doing? Aw, oh, fuck you. They are advancing and taking that territory that I wanted. Damn it. I need to go to war with them and stop them. Because I can't have them taking all this territory. Man, you are going really deep. Alright, so what did this do? I received an urgent message from the College of the Celestial. Alright, so you had to go send a dude there to discover the threat. Okay. First observations, so that the celestial wizards are closer to a definitive reading. Where their astral life requires certain adjustments and intricate additions in order to perform the calculation, it will require rare materials which will not come cheaply. Have a treasury of 10,000 at the start of a turn. Well, we already did that, so. Fund the astral life adjustments. Takes 5,000 away. Okay, well, we already did that, so. Good. Grows, raise an army. This would actually be really useful. So even though I didn't really want to make another army, I might do this anyway. Emperor orders his factors to secure the necessary materials. Alright, with the adjustments to the magic astral have completed, the wizards of the Celestial College report back their findings, and the portents cannot be more dire. A great orc war boss has arisen somewhere in the land south of the Black Mountains. His fearsome reputation has gathered many greenskin tribes behind him in a wog, which is now headed for the main route from the Badlands into the Empire, Black Fire Pass. The first priority is to prevent further orc warbands from traveling to join the wog. Meanwhile, messengers are sent to summon all allies to face the threat. Using the Emperor's army, defeat forces belonging to the Greenskins. That's not going to happen any fucking century soon, if in fact it ever happens. It very well may never happen at all. Very well may never happen at all. Yeah, just auto-resolve, blow up the place. Blow up the place. Raise it. I'm gonna have to pull you back, unfortunately. actually go into that mode. Can you get in the water? You can. Good. So that'll actually let you heal rather than take damage, because you're in friendly waters now. Somebody is moving on Bjornli, and I don't know who. Actually, a bunch of people, rather, are moving on there, but... See, you need to hurry the fuck up, dude, because you're about to have major problems. You're about to lose your army, basically. I don't know what the hell you think you're doing with these guys, but... Yeah, so... We've got problems over here. They're gonna if they come across the border to attack me, I don't even know what to do about that, because that's gonna be... It's gonna be really bad. I don't even know what to do about that if they come over here. What are you guys doing, anyway? The Skull Takers. Pretty sure you must be attacking, Scaling of Arg, but I don't know who precisely you intend to attack. Well, hopefully you'd kill each other, so... I'm okay with that, either way. If you kill each other, I'm totally okay with it either way, so... Okay, so there's... Winter Pyre. I have to figure out where the hell the Altar of Spawns is. I don't know if you guys are going to survive long enough to get to Aisling's Conclave. Because you're taking consistent damage here, just trying to cross through the territory, so... I don't know if you will be able to live long enough to get there. So much so, I think, that I'm actually going to reassign you to try to take out Winter Pyre. Because at least if you can kill something of theirs, it'll be good. I don't really care specifically what you kill, just as long as you kill something. So if you can destroy any of their provinces, I'll be happy. And we might have to go on war with these guys and start pushing them back, because... They come rolling up here with this stuff, I don't know if I can beat them. I don't know that we can beat them if they come rolling up in here and start taking all this territory and shit. Alright, get yourself down there into the town. Oh, I want to trade better troops here. I don't know. I think we have to wait for a minute until, Okay, so we need that built. That's a priority. Because that'll unlock basically all of the troops. So as soon as that's done, we'll be able to do a lot more in the area. In the meantime, I mean, I guess I could have you train some regular troops. Just some regular infantry or whatever, because you need some sort of infantry force. We have definitely learned that. Alright, go build halberders. Sure. Why not? Why not? You're not really the ideal forces that I would prefer to have, but that's fine. Okay, you're almost at full, so I might need to get moving with you guys to, do something. You know what I might want to do is just make an army. In fact, I think I'm going to do that. Let's do it this way. Let's recruit a hero. This will give us a... No, not a hero. A lord. There we go. This will give us a... force... This will give us the raise the banner thing, which will be helpful. And in fact, we can cancel that real quick and then get a little bit of money back. Not a lot, but a little bit. And every bit a little bit is helpful. So you would take... Alright, actually, I think that's worth it. Just sending this dude in completely by himself. To, like, retake Kislev. Probably Kislev, because we need to stop them from taking that province.
What does the Emperor bid?
Yeah, I'm okay with that.
Who calls?
Alright, so you've got two more turns before you're going to be fully good, but you're pretty much good now, if we stay within neutral, friendly territory, rather, for the moment. For the moment, at least. You'd be pretty good for the moment, right now. Maybe one more turn.
Yes. I am Prince Andrew.
But I need to figure out what I want to do with you, is the thing. Well, that's fine. I think we're good for now. Okay, so what do we got going on? You're at full. That's good. So let's go ahead. Did you finish? You did. Okay. All right. Yeah, let's kick the spearmen out. They're not good, so just get rid of them. They don't even have any levels or anything, so just go ahead and get rid of them. Train yourselves. Just give you a bunch of great swords, I think. Three great swords. That puts you back at full strength. Can't train anything else there anyway, so it's fine. Our income, of course, has dropped because we're, you know, training all these troops and shit, but... Oh, I wanted to build stuff here, but I can't afford it. Can't afford it, so that's fine. Alright, so... Okay, you're fine for the moment. See, these ones that are deep inland, unfortunately there's no way to really get to them to be able to kill them, which is the problem. Fortunately, we have destroyed all of their border territories now. All of their border regions that we can see easily are already destroyed, so... I think if we can manage to... push forward here.
Protector of the realm.
And drive them back a little bit. I think we might be pretty good. I think we need to go to war with these guys. Can't do it yet, but as soon as these armies are back into full strength, I think we need to go to war with these guys and try to kill them. Stop them from continuing to expand. Could actually send these two down here and do that. I don't know. I don't know if I want to do that. Alright, you know what? You're going to take way too long to get over there, so... we're going to send you over here and basically just have him start taking these territories. We need to get to the water and traverse around so we can hit Winter's Pyre. I think it's our best bet. And also make it easier if we can get into the water here. We can hit Winter's Pyre, then we can go inland and hit the Conclave. And we can traverse up here and probably find their other territories. So I think staying in the water is actually the ideal position, the ideal path here forward. Yeah, probably. It's probably what we want to do. Because I don't think it'll be really difficult, maybe not impossible, but extremely difficult to actually get up here to attack these guys. You'd have to, like, move, make sure you move just enough so that you can always go into encamp mode at the end of every turn. So you'd be very limited in how far you could move.
Summon the electric cards.
I don't know. The vampire counts at war with chaos? They are. Interesting. Alright, cool. Maybe chaos will come down here and solve some of my problems for me. If chaos attacks again, maybe they'll hit the vampire counts. Alright, I'm gonna hope that they do that, actually. So, rather than... I wish there was a way to, like, reserve.
Sigma compels us onward. Move!
Guess you just have to move very slowly and carefully. Since you can still encamp. Alright, so I know they're sending another army down, so we need to basically move in to try to handle that before they can get here. And I think, going to move up and try to kill the rest of their territory off. I think I want to do that, so... Send you forward. Let you do your thing. Okay, so that's how we're going to do this. So we have two armies now that are back to strength enough to be able to do offensive operations. Once we finish doing what we're doing over here with these guys, I will send them in, try to start taking some territory. I actually kind of want the vampire counts, now that I'm thinking about it, to go up there, because if they lose all their troops to chaos... Not only will they delay chaos, but they'll... If they lose their troops, I can basically go to war with them and just completely wipe the floor with them without even having to really do anything. If they lose all their shit to chaos. So, it's probably a better idea than doing anything else. No, I'm not going to join the war with the Skull Takers. I don't even know what the Skull Takers are anymore, but that's fine. Also, I need to make peace with those guys. I don't want to be at war with them. I don't want to be at war with you, so I need to make peace with you real quick. Where are you going? Why are you all just, like, wandering in circles for no fucking reason? Okay, so I think they're fighting the orcs. So that's good. Okay, so you're going to come down here and kill the Nord army, unfortunately. Unfortunately, you're going to go kill the Nord army, so that's going to be bad, but not much I can do about it, though. Oh, that's bad. That's very bad for our, for the dwarves. I could care less myself, but.
My throng stands ready. Do not disappoint me.
Yeah, so I'm gonna make a peace with you. I don't want to be at war with you. That doesn't serve me any purpose. I can make you a vassal. All right. Yeah. That should end your war with them. Yeah. Good. Okay, cool. So that just terminates the war with Tilia and the Border Princes. So actually that means now that I can actually talk to these guys and get more done with them.
I am ready to parley. I hope.
Possibly. Okay, well, so we've got the vampire counts that we still have to contend with. Fucking dwarves are just pressed on all sides by the greenskins, but because their own damn fault. Their own damn fault on that one. So, yeah. It's your own stupid ass fault there. Trying to decide if I should get Averland or Nordland to join me now. Like, would it be smart to do that? Oh, wait, what? What the fuck? What happened here? Oh, are you at war with... What the fuck? Did the dwarves come up and attack and destroy that territory or something? They must have. Because that was... Okay, well actually that might be worth my time then to get claim Averland so we can go take that territory. That might be worth doing. Yeah. Where's the Avalon army?
The Empire.
I don't know. I think you're just going to die. Because I think these guys are going to attack you and kill you. I'm just trying to decide if it's worth me doing this. Like, I can't save that army, most likely. They're probably going to die no matter what. But if I could get them to Winterpyre, destroy Winterpyre, get into the water. Actually, I don't know if you can go into the water. I can't control the army, so I can't tell. If I can get into the water, though, I could move around here and then move in and like take like here or something. So we would have a territory to reinforce that. And that might be useful. I don't know if I'd be able to succeed in that, though, at all, but... It would certainly be useful to do if we can do it. I just don't know if I can. I just don't know if we can. I'm not going to turn this into an actual army. At least not anytime soon, because there's just really no reason. Okay, you guys are fine now, I think. So let's go ahead. Do we go up this way? Try to catch this army and destroy it and help them destroy Winterpyre? Because if I do that, I might be able to save that army. And then we could move in and start killing them from that direction. Alright, yeah, maybe it's worth it. It might be worth it. Let's do it. Let's do it. As long as they only have like one army that we can have to engage with, we shouldn't have to worry too much. It's only when we have multiple armies.
The Empire.
Okay, so your army didn't get killed, so that's good. Send you in to kill these guys? Probably should. Probably should.
To battle, to arms, raise your
fuck.
Weapons. Cease, the nation calls. It is time. It is for the best. Onwards, this will bolster the nation.
Oh well. So I'm going to send you around to hit Ice Drake Fjord. Maybe between your two armies, if you manage to group them up, you might be able to kill one of these forces. And hopefully somebody is going to go hit Bjornlein's gathering at some point. We'll see, I guess. We will see, I guess. Alright, so we have to assign construction troops. obstruction of troops. Okay, you're doing what you need to be doing, so you're fine for the moment. You need to build that. You need to get some more infantry. Although, what all are we building here that we might need? Actually, not a whole lot that I can do much with. So we gotta wait for this to finish before we can upgrade anything here, so... Alright, fine. We'll just build more infantry here, then. I won't bother to try to build, like, better troops or anything. We'll just go with what we got. We'll just go with what we can easily build. I'll just turn this into a group of infantry. It's fine. We don't need necessarily anything spectacular in that army. Okay, so you... I'm waiting for that to finish. Fuck. I don't know that I necessarily want to build anything else with you, because I really want to build the better troops, which we can't build until the armor is complete. So I actually don't know that I want to build anything with you right now. I might be much better served just not bothering. Unless I build global stuff. Which I might, but this exact instant, there's no particular reason to do that. Alright, let's look around real quick. What all can we build that would be useful? Not a whole lot, I don't think. Not a whole lot. Okay, so that's fine. So you're building there. So we will come to here, and I will build global troops. Just because I want to build... I want to use up all my money, and I want to have good troops. In the process of being made, at least. So let's get, like, one steam tank. Maybe not more than one. Or maybe we could do two of them. It takes all my money, though. And I kind of want to use up all the global slots here. What can I afford to build two of? Build more Reichsguard. Maybe build... No, I wouldn't be able to build that. Shit. Well, actually, we need some of these guys, so let's do this. Let's get ourselves another group of halberd ones so that we have two of those. That takes the majority of the money, but we can then build... another group of you. Okay, so that gets a fair amount of troops being built there. And once this finishes all this building here, once that's done, I can build troops directly in this province so we can finish upgrading you. That's going to be it for this episode, folks. So thank you for watching. Like and subscribe. My plan here is going to be to move up with these armies to destroy the Varg from the... this side, basically, will move in, kill this army, take Winter Pyre, possibly build up one or two of these territories, I don't know. And then we'll move in and kill the Conclave and just kind of start working our way through the mountains here and just kill everything. I want to wipe these two out. I want them dead. So that's going to be my plan with these two armies. That's going to tie them up for quite a while. And really kind of with this army too, I guess. That's going to tie all those armies up for a long time, but... if we can wipe the threat from those guys out entirely, then, you know, that'll help us a great deal. And then we can, you know, move in, secure this territory, which is what this guy's gonna do. And, you know, it should be good. So, I will see you in the next episode, so take it easy. Have a good day. As always, of course, like and subscribe if you enjoy my stuff. It really does help me quite a bit. And I will see you in the next episode. So bye-bye, folks.